So this example, this robot that's going down the hall, it's got this noise sensor, this is perfect for sort of a probabilistic Bayesian filter-based tracker. And the reason is, first of all, it's going to have some continuous belief about where it thinks it might be. Right, so that's its belief, its distribution, its posterior about where it thinks, and its measurements are noisy. And furthermore, it's really unlikely that, depending upon its measurements, that it will have a nice Gaussian belief about where things are. Its belief is going to be whatever it is. So we're going to make use of a particle filter to do this. All right, what you're seeing here is this is the prior density. So here's our little. Should we name our robot? Sure. What's a good name? See, I would use some like R2-D2 kind of name, but then I would get sued by George Lucas, so we'll call it R3-D3. Okay, so R3-D3 is sitting over here, and this here, this is its prior belief about where it is right now. We have no idea how it got that value. This is its random distribution. And you can see it's a pretty uniform distribution of particles. Now the sensor reaches out and it gets a measurement. And let's just suppose it sticks its stick out and it sees a hole. What that means is the stick doesn't run into anything. So it says, ah, it's a hole. Now, using the sensor model, the robot has to evaluate not where it thinks it is, but first, what's the probability that I would see a hole if I was at each of these locations? So after the robot sees the hole, what it has to evaluate is, what is the likelihood that I would have seen a hole if I was at this location? So these values here, these are not the probability that I'm at that location given that I saw a hole. It's the probability that I would see a hole given that I was at that location. So the reason that it's highest in the middle is because even if I've got a wiggly stick over here, the likelihood that I see a hole is higher than if I'm sort of at the edge of the hole, right? Because then I might sometimes run into the wall, sometimes run into the hole. And that's why I have this nice tight little distribution like that, okay? So remember, that's not P of X given the hole. It's probably that I would see a hole given that I was an X. Then what do? Well, in our particle filter, we just multiply P of Z given X, probability of the hole given X, times my prior distribution for every one of these x's, okay? So that's what this distribution is down here. That is the multiplication of the prior times the likelihood. And in math, remember, the belief is proportional to the prediction, or my belief prior, that's this here, times my likelihood. That's this value here. And then I have to normalize the whole thing in order to get a new belief. Okay? That's why I'm doing it.